Hey, Alfred Brock here, and we're going to be talking about the A word. Brought to us from the Addiction Policy Forum, language matters. Language matters. When words are used inappropriately to describe individuals with a substance use disorder, it not only negatively impacts the cultural perception of their disease, but creates stigma that can stop people from seeking help. And we don't want to see that. We want to see people seeking help and reaching out and getting the help that they need. Language matters. Let's replace terms like addict and junkie with smarter language that aligns with the science of today, that aligns with what's going on in the world today. Replace the A word with individuals with a substance use disorder. And here are some other suggestions. Here's a do. Substance use disorder instead of substance abuse dependence. When we're talking about substance abuse and dependence, that is a physical state, but when we're talking about an individual, they've got a substance abuse disorder, all right? And they may be experiencing dependence, physical dependence, but that's different. Another two, individual with a substance use disorder. Now we're getting close to what I was talking about. Rather than addict, drug abuser, junkie, druggie. Hey, it's not good when other people use it. It's especially upsetting to me when people that have substance abuse disorders, substance use disorders, start referring to themselves as addicts, drug abusers, junkies, druggies, and saying that's their culture and their lifestyle and they're never going to get away from it. A individual with a substance use disorder can deal with it and work it out. Some other dudes, in recovery, in remission. That's great. In recovery, in remission, right? Don't. Being clean, staying clean. Again, falling into the nomenclature, falling into that language and exiting that lifestyle, we need to exit the language as well. Those words that have they just carry a lot of baggage, clean and staying clean. In recovery, in remission. So, do say has a substance use disorder. There you go. Someone's got a substance use disorder. I've got a substance use disorder. They've got a substance use disorder rather than a drug habit. A drug habit. As if some of these things, that's not a habit, okay? It's a physical dependence, and it's got to be dealt with. The body is definitely seriously entwined with some of these drugs, especially the opioids, and there's a lot of mental addiction and social addiction that goes along with others like methamphetamines and cocaine and things like that. So it's much less a habit. It is not a habit. It is a substance use disorder and all the things associated with it. So someone had a negative drug test. They didn't get a good drug test. That was a negative drug test. And they're not currently using substances, and that's good, right? So negative drug test. They got a negative drug test. They are not using the drugs there. They are currently not using substances. That's great. They have a negative drug test. Let's get more of those negative drug tests. Don't refer to it as a clean drug test. You got a clean drug test. Oh, sometimes I get a dirty one, and then I got a clean one. If I clean myself up, then I'll get a clean one. No, don't use drugs. Stay away from drugs. And then you will get a negative drug test. It's kind of switched around there for me because a positive drug, you know, you're not using drugs. You don't got to, it's nothing recorded in there. To me, that's positive, right? But a positive drug test is not good for jobs. It is not good in life. It's just not good. So a negative drug test is good if you get a negative drug test. Referring to it as a clean drug test, say clean, dirty, those words don't belong here. Okay. And then do positive drug test. Currently using substance. Stop doing that. You know, if you get a positive drug test, that is not positive to get a positive drug test. So currently using substances. Please do something about it. Reach out. Get help so you don't do that. But let's not refer to it as a dirty drug test. Oh, it's dirty. Because you're adding something onto it mentally, socially, and through the word, you're adding something that doesn't belong there. Okay? But just like the drugs don't belong in the body, trying to leap it on there, you know, heap it on there. Dirty drug test. Got to get clean. Stopping taking drugs and dealing with the substance abuse has got nothing to do with being dirty and clean. Not a thing. Not a thing. So this was brought to you from the addiction. They brought to you from Alfred Brock, but I'm reading off material from the Addiction Policy Forum. And you can learn more by going to JAMA and finding out, looking for Changing the Language of Addiction by Michael Botticelli. And Howard Koh, K-O-H, so that's Michael Botticelli, B-O-T-T-I-C-E-L-L-I, and Howard Koh, K-O-H, and it's called Changing the Language of addiction. And then also, you can follow up with language, substance use disorders, and policy, the need to reach consensus on an addictionary. Oh, that's kind of clever, right? Okay, we'll go with that for now. But that's put out by John F. Kelly, Richard Saltz, and Sarah Wakeman. So that second one was language, substance use disorders, and policy, the need to reach consensus on an addictionary. To get the language going, even the doctors and psychiatrists are dealing with this, and the sociologists and our social workers are dealing with this, okay? And that last one is written by John F. Kelly, Richard Saltz, and Sarah Wakeman. Thanks for paying attention today, and do the best you can. Be happy, be healthy. Bye-bye.